With the following amendment, deleted item number eight.
Mr. Chair, I can make a motion to accept the agenda with the following amendment to delete item number eight.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Bazur. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Can I have an acceptance of the minutes of the meeting held June 4, 2019, and dispense with the oral reading?
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Remick, supported by Councilwoman Cross. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Okay, this takes us to Mayor Communications. Mayor Sellers, you got anything tonight?
Mr. Chairman, thank you. Nothing official tonight.
Okay. Okay, this takes us to the regular part of the agenda. Item number six is a motion to approve payment to the Michigan Fire Training Consultants in the amount of $5,795 for flashover training.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Pat, supported by Councilman Remick. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item number seven is a motion to approve the low bid to McMillan Group, Detroit, Michigan, to demolish a single-family structure with garage located at 14336 Pine Street. Cost of demolition is not to exceed $9,250. Funds provided from building department / demolitions.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item eight is a motion to approve a contract between takes us to item number nine, is a motion to receive and file May 2019 paid invoice report.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Winton, supported by Councilman Bazura. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item number 10 is a motion to receive and file May 2019 budget performance report.
Motion. Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Remick, supported by Councilwoman Winton. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item number 11 is a motion to approve July 2019 payroll.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Remick, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item number 12 is a motion to approve a permit for Elliott's Amusement to hold a carnival at the Taylor Summer Festival from June 27th through 30th, 2019. All city requirements to obtain a carnival permit have been met.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Winton, supported by Councilman Bazur. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 13 is a motion to approve the purchase of laptops to be utilized as electronic poll books through CDW-G, low quote, in the amount not to exceed $4,750. Funds to be allocated through General Fund Clerk's Office voting equipment.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Pat, supported by Councilwoman Wynn. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chair, can the clerk please explain to the residents what this means?
Sure.
Sure, Bob.
Sure. Mr. Chair, an electronic poll book is basically, I've been voting for a while. We used to have paper books where it was a list of voters and everyone's sticker put it on paper to keep track of who voted. The electronic poll book took the place of the paper book, and when a voter walks in, they're checked in on the computer, and it is a record of their it's also, it speeds up the process. We have to download and vote, and it's not, we take the U.S.
books do you use? There's so many precincts.
There's one per precinct.
But you're only asking for nine.
And at this time, nine, and I will buy more at the first year, we'll get more. First, this later, I should say.
Is there any other discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 14 is a motion to approve payment to One Beacon in the amount of $151,384 for a two-year extended reporting period from May 9, 2019 through May 8, 2021, paid by Nickel and Sapp, Inc., City's agent of record, to be funded from General Fund Risk Management Contractual Services.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chair, could we have Doris Mitchell come up just to explain to residents? I know we don't hear this, but...
Chairman, Council, Mayor. This item here is an approval for what we call a supplemental extended policy. And what this will do is, since we now have a new carrier that we've engaged with for May 9th of 2019, any of the current claims that are still covered under the One Beacon policy, as well as any claims for dates of loss prior to May 9th of 2019, would still be covered under the previous policy. So One Beacon will basically be kind of covering any potential claims that may have come. There are certain claims that have a statutory period and they may not be filed for 2 to 3 years. So this covers us. And any claims that have a date of loss from May 9th of 2019 onward would be covered by our new carrier.
Is there any other discussion? Okay, if not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 15 is a motion to approve payment in the amount of $11,700 to National Paid Home Buyers for the down payment assistance for home buyers number 2019-05 and 2019-06, and this is funded through the home grant.
Motion. Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Pat, supported by Councilman Johnson. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 16 is a motion to approve setting a public hearing for July 2nd, 2019 at the regular scheduled City Council meeting. The public hearing will be allowed for public input in regards to the presented Community Development Block Grant Action Plan budget for the 2019-2020 program year.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Remick. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 17 is a motion to approve PCMG LOPO for firewall support renewal for an amount not to exceed $6,429, funded through IT Contractual Services.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Bezerra. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 18 is a motion to approve integration partner sole source for network management suite software maintenance under special manufacturer promotion for an amount not to exceed $8,800, funded through IT Contractual Services.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Wynn, supported by Councilman Remick. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chairman, can we have Mr. Patel come up and explain why there's just a sole source here?
Thank you, Chairman. Through Chair to Council, this product is purchased in 2011, part of one of the OIA product, which is Network Management Suite that manages the actual hardwire network and also wireless network. And OIA bought out by the Extreme Network, and they just at this conference before, and they have promotion going on that total MSRP was like $45,000 product. They're going to give it to us for just paying a maintenance for 1 year or 2 year maintenance. And the part of the promotion was the purchase only to be done by Integrated Partner, which is the initial purchaser of the software. That's the reason we came out of this whole story.
Thank you. Okay, is there any other discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item number 19 is a motion to approve fiscal year 2018-2019 budget amendment number 2019-016.
Motion. Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Reimer, supported by Councilwoman Witten. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion